Squadron number 45, the Flying Daggers, now flying the Tejas, has recorded over 1,000 sorties since its formation in July 2016. The Flying Daggers have now moved out of Bengaluru to Air Force Station Sulur, its permanent base, officially from July 1. The SP-10 completed its maiden flight recently and will hand it over this month. With the squadron moving to Sulur, we cannot now run the show at the same pace. After 2 years, we have only added another 7 more to the fleet. The squadron needs to be strengthened and all teething issues sorted out immediately. The production and design agencies, HAL and ADA, must step on the gas, says an IAF officer. HAL meanwhile has to deliver the pending 7 fighters, SP-10 to SP-16, to IAF to complete the IOC block, minus the trainers. There are trainers now, PV-5 and PV-6, which are being extensively used for training pilots and also for completing certain test points of FOC as well. The ministry has also agreed that the HAL will supply 8 trainer aircraft out of 40, after the 32 Tejas Mk-1 have been supplied. IAF will receive 16 fighters in the IOC format and another 16 in the FOC format. All these will be LCA Mki. In the next version of 83 aircraft which are to be built as per the LCA Mk-1A standards, there will be 10 trainers. All the 18 trainers, 4 plus 4 plus 10, will be of LCA Mk-1 standards and not Mk-1A. The first SP trainer will be a prototype fitted with our probe to evaluate probe performance on a trainer. HAL says it expects the lead time for production of a trainer with our probe, from the release of drawings, is approximately 30 months. IAF will have to probably wait till 2021 to get the Tejas trainer of their liking. Ramping up the Tejas production will be based on USPV, Special Purpose Vehicle, model, or USBU, Strategic Business Unit, model. The government wants to bring HAL and ADA together. IAF needs Tejas in large numbers, and the only way to achieve this is through a fresh look to overcome delays. The structural gap between HAL and ADA, a prime cause of Tejas delay, has to be bridged, and we feel IAF can do it. The government has given the go-ahead to hand over the entire Bengaluru complex of HAL to the IAF. With this, the fixed-wing aircraft division will come under the IAF. The modalities are being worked out, says an official that may take a few months. In addition, 3 institutions, Aeronautical Development Agency, ADA, Aeronautical Development Establishment, ADE, and Gas Turbine Research Establishment, GTRE, which are under the Defense Research Development Organization, DRDO, are likely to be brought under the direct control of the Chief of the Air Staff. Thus, the entire development cycle of the LCA will have the IAF's oversight and will ensure timely execution and prevent blame games over delays, the source observed. Sources also said IAF now wants SDR, software-defined radio, on board all FOC platforms, a latest addition, which was not envisaged earlier. IAF wants new data links as a standard feature on the FOC variant, as communications are an essential feature for an aircraft to operate in a network-centric environment. Defense Ministry official said this is likely to be delayed by another 6 months, as several parameters like gun firing, new data-linked software-defined radios, among others, are yet to be validated. HAL quoted the price of Rs 463 crore per Mk-1A jet in April. The committee is headed by principal advisor in the ministry and is likely to submit its report. Once the committee submits its report, the ministry will form a commercial negotiations committee to bring down HAL's price for the jet. HAL has moved ahead with the parts for the first FOC fighter, originally SP-21, being already being loaded onto the assembly facility in Bengaluru. Production for FOC aircraft will be taken up after FOC clearance by the ADA, for which the current target is December 2018. The first prototype of the Mk-2 is expected to make its debut flight in 2022-23, and complete the IOC and FOC approvals in the next 5 years. The current target is to have the first squadron ready by 2028. Within the next 5 months, a made-in-India Tejas fighter jet will touch down briefly on the deck of the Navy's aircraft carrier INS Vikram Aditya before taking off again. The series of touch-and-go landings is meant to demonstrate the ability of the fighter to operate safely off the deck of India's only operational aircraft carrier. If everything goes as planned, two Tejas Navy prototypes will begin full-fledged flight tests off Vikram Aditya deck by the end of 2019. This will involve landing, refueling and taking off. The hook-wire combination violently slows down the Tejas from its landing speed of 125 knots, approx 230 km, to 0 knots in under 4 seconds. Tejas Navy technology demonstrator to pave the way for a fully operational Tejas fighter deployed on an Indian aircraft carrier, a process that could take up to a decade. The Navy has refused to fund but MOD have volunteered to fund the Navy's part, provided ADA achieves some milestones. In its present test configuration, it isn't powerful enough to carry an ideal number of weapons such as missiles and bombs. To address this, ADA will need to build a larger aircraft with a more powerful engine. The design parameters of that new variant of the Tejas jet can only be locked down and finalized once the technology demonstrator flying today finishes its final tests.